Hi. I think I'm. Is this gonna be the beginning? This is confusing. I think it is. Okay, I'm gonna do an opening and then you're gonna see a different scene and then we're gonna come back here and talk some more. So, I'm exhausted. I have not slept in 24 hours, so I'm really tired. Hi, Shani Fannies. Welcome to Educating Shani. I'm Shani and I'm recovering from an eating disorder. Hi, Shani. Hi. Okay, so. I wanted to sit down tonight and right before I went to bed and make a video talking about the fact that I reached my 1 year eating disorder behavior free mark thing that you want to call it. This is something I've been dreaming about forever. Leave it to me to screw that up. I had a slip up. I documented the whole thing about how I felt afterwards because I'm trying to. I have therapy on Thursday and I have a feeling that because I've been asked this in the past but I've never truly done it, he might like recommend like, hey, if you do mess up, document how you're feeling. So either journal or video or whatever. So that's what I did tonight. So I'm going to show you that clip and then we'll come back and talk. Okay, I don't know if I'm going to use this for therapy or if I'm gonna post it, but I just binged and purged and I'm gonna document how I feel right after and my thoughts and try and like figure out how this happened this time. So today we start our podcast, me and Jeremy from TikTok. And I've been really nervous about it, and one of the things I'm recognizing is that all the mess ups that I've had over the past year, the 7 mess, well now 8, but the 7 always happened when something really, new and either exciting or stressful or both, or something that's just a change, I'm noticing that that is still triggering me. So I just want to document that. My mom would tell me all the time growing up that like change was the hardest thing for me. Like even the smallest change, like moving from, you know, preschool to kindergarten or in like church, moving from one age group to the next in a different class and stuff. And I remember this too. She had to go with me everywhere until I was 12, probably. And I had to be sitting on her lap when I was really little and just would not let her go and would not let her leave me anywhere that she wasn't going to be with me. And she just said, since the beginning, I've always had a hard time to change in so many different ways. And that's true. Like, change is really, really hard for me. So I don't know. It's weird because I've done a lot of changing over the past year, but obviously this new, scary, exciting, fun, am I going to be able to do this, obviously triggered something. So I just thought I'd document this and be honest about it. So, and I'm in my closet. You're welcome. Okay, goodbye. And it sucks, like, I don't want this to be an issue, and I was afraid this would happen, and I think that deep down, I knew that it might happen, because it's my go-to comfort when things are changing and different and hard and new and even exciting. Like, I haven't been able to sleep. I think I've been up for 24 hours now. I haven't been able to sleep. I haven't been able to eat very much, and the much that I did eat turned into lots of much, and then a throw up, and I'm going to do my best to remember that slip-ups happen, and if anything, I'm actually super proud of myself for, like, turning on the camera right after, like, it literally just happened, so if I look really swollen, that's why. And just try and document how I'm feeling, I guess. I don't know. I guess I'm feeling disappointed. I don't feel surprised at all, which makes me think that subconsciously I was like planning or at least leaving that option open. I'm feeling sick. I feel like I'm gonna pass out and die. Like, I feel really sick, which is good and bad because my body's gotten so old and so frail over the years that now if I binge and purge once, like, my body's not used to that anymore, and so now I'm getting sick after binging and purging, whereas before I would feel better if I binge and purged, and when I days and nights that I didn't binge and purge, I felt sicker, and that's because my body was addicted to it. And so it is a good sign that I'm feeling really sick after doing this. In fact, I'm gonna go lay down. I think I'm gonna pass out. Okay, goodbye. I just realized something else. I remember that right before I turned my normal bedtime eating into a binge, I remember feeling really nauseous, and it hit me that I ran out of one of my medications a couple days ago, and it's for nausea. It's Phenagrin, promethazine. And I take it every day, and it occurred to me, like, ooh, can you get withdrawals from that? Because maybe I was feeling like extra nauseous and extra sick and stuff. So I do know that that was part of my stupid Ed thinking that was like, okay, well, you know, you feel sick, you know, you can't sleep, you know that you're probably going to throw up anyway, so you might as well go eat half a box of cereal and throw it up. And so I did. I'm just trying to like document all my thoughts and feelings right now. So sorry, this isn't like super emotional because I'm just like documenting how I'm thinking and feeling right now. I'm sure I'll be emotional later, but right now I'm just like, oh, what happened? Let's do this XYZ. How did this happen? Which is good. Like, I'm proud of myself for doing this. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Some sleep. This just sucks, you know, but at the same time, I'm obviously very, very proud of myself. I've come a long way, and I know that there are people that are gonna attack and just assume that I'm this completely sick, hasn't healed at all person, but that's just simply not the truth. And I'm really proud of how far I've come. I hate that I messed up today. I hate that I messed up twice in the past week. I hate that I messed up on the video for the video that I was going to announce that I was a year free of it, and it sucks, but it's life and it's recovery, and these things happen. And I'm not gonna lie, I think deep down I knew this would happen, I think, and that's important for me to recognize. I think that deep down in my head I was like, okay, once I reach the 1 year, I can get away with doing it, because then I can still say it. I did it for a year, so I can still get away with it. So I feel like that's like really important to note, and I'm just trying to take it minute by minute. And I've never truly committed to doing this before, where I document like hour by hour what I'm feeling right after it happened, what I'm thinking, what I'm feeling, and hopefully the tears will come at some point. They haven't come yet. Hopefully they will, maybe tomorrow when I'm well rested. I haven't slept in a long time. But like, it's like this video is so bittersweet, because obviously I just had a mess up the day after my 1 year recovery. But also I have a 1 year recovery, and that's amazing. And I'm making the conscious effort right now to talk about it and to not let it just consume me and give up, because it would be so easy at this point to be like, okay, well, I've already done it for a year, so I can have a few more mess ups. I can mess up. Okay, I messed up today. Okay, well, let's just do it again tomorrow and the next day and the next day. You know, I deserve it. Like, I've earned a week full of binges and purges because I went a whole year. I'm just not allowing myself to think that way anymore. But obviously I still have my problem, right? Like, and I'll always have my eating disorder, but I think I'm getting to the point in my life, I think, where I just don't think I have any time to bullshit around anymore. And like, I'm not, that's the thing. Like, this is just a slip up, and it's not like I'm bullshitting anything, but my point is that I can't fall back into that deep where I was. I'm 1000% positive that if I fall back into where I was, that I will die like within the year. So it's just not an option, and I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful that my body is beating me up on the mess up. When the very few mess ups happened, my body felt like it was gonna die, and yeah, that was scary and it sucked, but I'm also grateful because that was like an incentive to not do it again. So, and today that's being proven again. I don't know what else to say. I wanted to like, oh, let's talk about my emotions and let me cry and let it out, but I think I'm just so tired. I'm like slurring my words, that's how tired I am, sorry. I'm so exhausted. I'm really stressed and I'm really anxious, and so maybe after I'm well rested, maybe I'll turn on the camera and see if anything comes out in the morning. But if not, then this is the video for you. You're welcome. This is the end of it. So in case this is the end, excuse me, thank you for your love and your support. I'm going to do a different video, not this one. My next video, I'm going to answer your questions about my recovery, and because I asked you guys to leave me some questions in yesterday's video about my 1 year recovery, and you guys left me some, and they're really good questions, and I do want to answer them, and I want to tell you like how I did it and what kept me going and all the things. So, but I just didn't feel it was appropriate to do it in this video, and I wanted to be honest with you guys because I'm always honest with you. I either always go live right away, or I make a video right away, or I message one of you right away and end up telling the whole internet within a few hours anyway. So like I've always been honest with you guys about it, and I would like to save that video of, you know, how I did it and all that for when I'm in a more aware and not so exhausted state of mind. And also, it just feels weird talking about it after my little slip up tonight. So so the next video you see after this, I will answer your questions. I know I said it would be this video, but it's not. It's gonna be the next video. But I'm trying to get on to making more videos for you guys too, and the podcast. We're starting recording today. I'm so nervous. Oh my gosh, it's gonna be amazing. I'm really, really excited, but I think I've talked about that enough at this point. So I'm just gonna stop talking and go to sleep, because I'm literally falling asleep right now. I just wanna say, before I go, fuck Ed. I know what you're doing. I know your little games, Ed. I know that you're like, hey, guess what, Shani, guess what? You made it a whole year. You never thought you could do that, so you might as well just mess up. Oh, you did mess up. Oh, okay, let's do it again tomorrow, and the next day, and the next day. Like, Ed, fuck you to hell where you belong. I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Seriously, thanks for your support. I love you guys, and we'll chat more tomorrow or the next day, whenever my next video is. We'll chat more about positive things. So, but I'm proud of myself. I'm super proud of myself. And I'm 1,000% proud of myself. Even with the slip up, I'm growing. So I'm proud. I love you guys. I'll see you soon. Remember forever and always that you're beautiful, you are worth it, and I am too. Thank you for watching. Bye. Oh, I wonder if I could play that. Thank you for watching. Bye. Thank you for watching.